Jantar Mantar observatories in India were built by the astronomer king Sawai Jai Singh early in the 18th century. And this was about 100 years after the telescope was first turned towards the skies. And it makes one wonder, why did he build non-telescopic masonry observatories of the nature that he did? And his primary interest had been towards accurate positional astronomy measurements. When he found theoretical calculations not tallying with observations, his intention was to make gigantic instruments and thereby get better least count, and take an entire data set, ephemeris data set, and use that as a basis for further calculations, theoretical calculations. And therefore, he set about to build these gigantic masonry observatories, and whose functionalities in many complex and interesting ways, they mimic the movement of objects in the sky. So they are like, you can walk through spherical trigonometry when you are actually at these instruments, and that is what makes them so alive. And their primary functionalities to some extent is to do, essentially to do with movement of objects in the sky, and from those movements either to get time or basically just measure the actual positions of these objects in the sky. And these positions could then be measured in a number of coordinate systems. So this in essence is the sum total of what is the usage of all the instruments in the observatory. Sawai Jai Singh built these Jantar Mantar observatories in 5 locations. The first one was built here in Delhi, and following that in Jaipur, Ujjain, Varanasi and Mathura. The one in Mathura is no longer extant, but all the other observatories are extant. And he built them also, he had one use in his mind, that of making ephemeris observations, and another was, and he explicitly mentioned this in Jizya Muhammad Shahi, the work which came out of these observatory observations, was that he wanted these observatory instruments to be there in public space. He wanted the citizen to be able to come into the observatory and take their own observations, and therefore appreciate how is it that astronomers do these observations. The Ram Yantra at the Delhi Jantar Mantar Observatory, and these are present also at the Jaipur Observatory. These are beautiful cylindrical instruments which are meant to take measurements in the local coordinate system. So these measure the local positions of the angular height above the sky, the altitude and the azimuth of an object in the sky. And these are built as cylindrical instruments, the inner surface of the cylinder being a reflection of the sky, every point in the sky being a point on the inner surface of the cylinder. And now the instrument is actually cut into segments. There are 30 sectors, flow sectors, 30 wall sectors and so on, so that people can walk into the instruments and then take measurements. And therefore, the pieces which have gone out through these cuts have been put into the complementary instrument. So Ram Yantra is made in 2 complementary cylindrical instruments, and where there are gaps in one of the instrument, there are sectors in the other. Where there are gaps in the other instrument, there are sectors in this. And now how does this function? This has a central pillar inside, and which is working as a gnomon. It's the shadow of the pillar or against the pillar one sees the nighttime objects. And this is built in such a way that the angular height of the pillar and the height of the wall of the cylinder and the floor length of the cylinder are all the same. And basically, if one takes the sun position, falls against this pillar and then falls somewhere on the floor of the Ram Yantra, and it is this angle which is the altitude, the angle that this line makes with the floor. And this can then be measured using simple trigonometry, and from the fact that the pillar height and the wall height and the floor length are the same, what happens is that when an object in the sky, let us say the sun, has an altitude of 45 degrees, The shadow of this falls in the junction between the wall and the floor. When it has an altitude of 0 degrees, it falls at the top of the wall. When it has an altitude of 90 degrees, sun of course never does have that in Delhi. It falls at the central pillar part of it. So in the radial direction, one measures the altitude of an object, and in the circumferential direction, one measures the azimuth, which this being a linear scale, this has trigonometry involved into it, and therefore this is non-linear. And so this is a very simple instrument for measuring altitude and azimuth, though it looks very intriguing and people are really perplexed when they look at this instrument, but it has very simple usage, and when one actually uses it, one realizes how user friendly it is. We are standing here to the south of the Samrat Yantra, so a gigantic equinoctial sundial, equal hour sundial, the largest one being the Brihat Samrat Yantra at Jaipur, and this just a little smaller than that. And the gigantic nature of the instrument allows us to take time measurements to 2 seconds, which is its least count. Now the instrument functions through its the main part of the instrument, which casts the shadow, which will be the gnomon, is the central triangular, the right angle triangle with an angle inscribed in it, so supposedly which should be equal to the latitude of this location, and then the hypotenuse of the triangle pointing towards the north celestial pole, and aligned north-south direction, perpendicular to that, parallel to the plane of the equator, are these giant arcs which are on either side. And in the original instrument, the arcs went, the floor level was lower than this, which was filled up due to waterlogging at some stage, and went and met the gnomon at the center. So 6 hours of time are inscribed in each of these arcs parallel to the equator, and according to the sundial, as the sun is rising, it hits the shadow hits the top 6 a.m. according to the sundial, the shadow disappears here 12 noon according to the sundial, shadow hits the top that side, and it's 6 p.m. according to the sundial, and so on. And then corrections, of course, to be added to that, both because of the longitude of our current civil time, also the equation of time. The Jayaprakash, it's a bowl shaped instrument. In some sense, it's a complete positional astronomy instrument, and it exists in Delhi observatory, much larger scale, and in the Jaipur observatory on a little smaller scale, currently under renovation here in Delhi. And the Ram Yantra, which we had a look at, Ram Yantra gives one measurements of local coordinates of any object in the sky. However, we also need to get information in other coordinate systems, particularly equatorial and ecliptic kind of coordinate systems, to get full information about celestial objects. And Jayaprakash is one such instrument which can give all of these coordinate measurements. So this is a bowl shaped instrument. So the surface of the bowl is a reflection of the sky. Every point in the sky is a point on the bowl, reflected through this crosswire, the center of the crosswire hung above it. And once again, the bowl is cut into segments so that observers can walk in and actually take observations of the shadow. And therefore, a bit of the instrument is missing. So it's built in complementary two hemispheres, two bowl shaped instruments, where there are gaps here, there are sectors there, and where there are gaps there are sectors here. And because you have the whole sky in your hand here, you can make any measurement that you like. Firstly, the local measurements themselves. So this is reflection of the central point of this bowl is a reflection of the zenith, and in the circumferential direction here, one can take measurements of the azimuth of an object reflected through this crosswire at the top. And once again, in the radial direction, one can measure the altitudes of object. So this instrument here, these the markings that you see here, these are for the local coordinate measurement. There is this portion in towards the southern side, which is actually a reflection of the northern side of the sky, the center of which, the perpendicular from that, will go towards the north celestial pole, the pole star. And the circle here is actually then showing us the circumpolar stars. And so along the equator there are time measurements also present. So this instrument can do local coordinates, equatorial coordinates, time measurements. In addition, there are also additional functionalities built in which would tell about the rise or culmination of the various zodiacal signs. So a complete instrument. The Mishra Yantra in the Delhi Jantar Mantar Observatory. It's iconic of the city of Delhi and it's a unique instrument present here in this observatory, and it is thought to have been built not by Jai Singh but perhaps by his son Mother Singh, who also had some interest in astronomy. And unlike many of the other instruments in the Jantar Mantar observatories, which are purely measurement oriented, this instrument is more pedagogical and it has possibilities of teaching, understanding various coordinate etc. involved in this. And it's a mixed instrument, mix and match kind of an instrument, and that's how it's called Mishra Yantra. So its aesthetics, its beauty is defined by these circles, the what are called the Niyat Chakra, the marble circles on either side. The instrument aligned north-south, and like the Samrat Yantra, it has these triangular walls which are the gnomons, and whose shadow falling, for instance, on the quadrants on either side, analogous to the Samrat Yantra, will tell the time. And in between, the morning and the afternoon half of the Samrat Yantra part of this instrument is the Niyat Chakra, which is built for understanding the annual movement of the sun. One can measure declination of the sun and other celestial objects in this. The Niyat Chakra, the arcs here, actually define meridians on different locations. The central one, the triangle wall defining the meridian of this location, and two meridians on either side. And when the sun is transiting the meridian on corresponding to these locations, these parts of the instrument become active, and they allow you to measure the declination of the sun four times during the day. And it's like just picking up by hand. Nowhere is an instrument where measurement of declination of the sun is as simple as it happens to be in the Mishra Yantra. So that's the beauty of this instrument, and throughout the year one can see the annual movement of the sun. So all in all, this is an instrument which allows equatorial kind of measurements in a very simple way. Understand these, the difference between the local and the equatorial ones through the instrument. The instrument is also a little bit mixed with other functionalities. The back wall of it, called the Karkara Shivalaya, has ecliptic coordinate measurements possibility inside it. And on one of the walls, the eastern wall, is a instrument in the meridian plane called Dakshinottara Bhitti Yantra. And these were the instruments which were built initially when the observatory first was built anywhere, because gigantic Dakshinottara Bhitti Yantra, which would allow the meridian altitude sun measurements, would give the accurate latitudes of the location, based on which then the rest of the instruments in the observatory would be built.